and his people. Yeah, I think they all really liked it. They really did. You know, sadly, Moon wasn't alive at that point, but the other three, Entwistle and Townsend and Daughtry, yeah, they really liked it.
New generations have constantly rediscovered Quadrophenia over the past 35 years. How does that make you feel?
Oh, it's fantastic for us, because it's sort of, whatever you do, whatever film you make or whatever album you make, you always reflect on it later and think, wow, could I have done that better? Or could I have remixed that better? Or could I have edited that better? That's the nature of what we do, you know. So it's real. It's a real endorsement to see it still being shown on TV, to see people rediscovering it. I've been working for some time now on what I could see as a sequel to Quadrophenia, where we pick up Jimmy a number of years later. And it's looking really good. So I think I've got a chance with that, you know. So I'd really like to make the sequel, because I think a lot of people, they're not sure whether he went over the cliff with the scooter or whether he didn't. And if he didn't, what happened to Jimmy? Or, for that matter, what happened to any Jimmy? Because the whole point about the film and its appeal was that most of the people that went to see it, young people, identified with Jimmy. That's me.